Zhao Yunlei. This is their third appearance here at the Singapore Open, and seeing as on their two previous occasions they've won the title, they've obviously never lost in this event. Zhao Yunlei, 29 years of age now, and she and her partner have been world number ones. A total of 42 weeks as world number ones, two different spells. First of all in 2012 and then in 2014 as well. So both the players, 29 years of age, and they had a real battle yesterday in their quarterfinal against Della Destiara Harris and Rosita Ica Putrisari. Dropped the opening game there before coming back in the decider. They've already won a tournament this year. The Chinese pair won the Thailand Masters Grand Prix Gold event. But their opponents have won three titles already this year. Malaysia Grand Prix Gold, the All England, and the India. Both of those, the last two, Super Series events. As we look at Mizaki Matsutomo, the 24-year-old from Tokushima. Her partner, Ayaka Takahashi, will turn 26 next Tuesday. She's from Nara in South Central Honshu. Current world number ones, and they've won all of their matches in two straight games, including their teammates in the quarterfinal yesterday, Shizuka Matsuo and Mami Naito, the left and right-handed combination. So, the Japanese pair, well, they've been beaten in the final here twice. Not only did they lose to their opponents of today in 2013, but they lost in the final last year. Lost out to Udong Ni and Yu Xiao Han. So there is the umpire that I was telling you about earlier, Kang Sung Young, and Iris Metspalu of Estonia, the service judge. Well, this will be the 14th meeting between these two pairs. And of the previous 13, well, the world and Olympic champions, Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei, have the advantage, having won nine of them. But the last time they met was at the All England Championships, the first of the Super Series events earlier this year, in the quarterfinal stage. An hour and 16 minutes it was for the Japanese pair to win through that. And
ladies,
of course, they went on to win the title.
On my right, Zhao Yunlei and Tian Qing, China. And on my left, Takahashi Ayaka and Matsutomo Misaki, Japan. Zhao Yunlei to serve to Takahashi Ayaka.
So the umpire getting the score pad ready.
Play.
And all set. First of our semi-finals gets underway. World number ones playing against the former world number ones. I think we can expect to see many a rally like that. Forty shots as an opening rally. Service fault called. bat struck above the waist. Oh, Tiang Qing. Yeah, I agree. Good call. Several rules in badminton regarding the serve. The shuttle must be struck below the waist, and the waist is defined as below the lowest rib. Racket must be pointing in a downward direction, not allowed to move your feet. Must strike the base of the shuttle first. One forward motion of the racket. A whole host of serving regulations, which is why we have a dedicated service judge. She's improved so much. I was commenting on that during the All England Championships.
3-2.
And in India. Block defense. She moves forward. Matsutomo, ready for the kill. Almost like a completely different player. She's improved her net play so much. With the Japanese pair winning the All England title, Matsutomo and Takahashi. First Japanese winners of the All England women's doubles for 38 years, since Takuda and Takada back in 1978.
5-2.
He's clever. Saw that Tiang Qing was encroaching forward, trying to put pressure on her opponents, so they just flicked it over her head. It's a good smash too. And this is a very, very good start by the current world number ones. Very clever smash. Waiter committed to the forehand defense. Tiang Qing hit it down her backhand side. So the run comes to an end, but five straight points there.
3-7.
Puts the Japanese pair in a very strong position in the early stages of this opening game. Oh, look at that. What great disguise on the drop shot from Ayaka Takahashi. Look at that. In fact, he got the net cord. Well, I know I said it during the All England, but this Japanese pair now playing an attacking style, and my goodness, aren't they a much better pair for it? Change of tactics, maybe a change of belief as well in themselves. I guess if there's a weakness with the Japanese pair, it's getting them out of their favoured formation, which is make this lady play at the front of the court, because normally she prefers playing at the back. Matsutomo usually prefers intercepting the shuttle at the front of the court. Yeah, this is their forehand formation. Oh, goodness, that's missed by a country mile. What on earth was she thinking? Caught on their defense a little too often. They've become predictable. They. What's the problem here? Oh, no, it's a dispute over whether to change a shuttle or not. Chinese wanted to change it. The Japanese pair said no. Yes, I think the Chinese players are a little too committed to either the forehand or backhand defense, and I think they're getting caught out a number of times now. A 3-point advantage at the mid-game interval here in the opening game. Yeah, the rotational play of the Chinese pair, not as smooth as it used to be. Working in sync as much nowadays.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Initially, unbelievable defense from Matsutomo, crouching down low rather than playing the backhand defense. And it's no wonder she got found wanting. Yeah, you can't move from down there. And therefore, vulnerable to that little block. Olympic champion, of course, in London in 2012, Xiao Yunlei won gold in both the women's doubles and the mixed doubles. First player to achieve that, although she's not the first player to win two Olympic gold medals. The first one to do so at the same Olympic Games. Opportunity for Tian Qing.
Let's go. 10, 30.
hesitation. Yeah, they're just not working. I said earlier, they're not working in sync.
14,
and they certainly aren't. Played together for long enough. Tianqing and Zhao Yunlei. Yeah, they really should know who's taking that one down the middle. But that said, it was particularly good placement by the Japanese players. That's a couple of times when Tianqing has made an error. The Zhao Yunlei throws her head back in, I don't know whether it's disgust or disappointment. Look at that. Oh, both of them. Better shot from Tianqing. Another error from Tianqing.
15, 11.
I wonder if there was hesitation. Did she wonder if it was going long? Yeah, I think it was hesitation. Make some ends with a turn of serve on the very next 12, point that wins the rally.
16.
Service fault called.
Service.
Called again on Tianqing.
Tianqing, please come here.
Yeah, it is high. It is high, I agree. The service judge is absolutely right.
17-12.
There's our service judge keeping a strict eye on things. Big Danish swipe on the backhand there from Matsutomo. That's lovely. That is Zhao Yunlei doing what she does best. Getting forward to the net. And dominating the front court area. Powers from the back, 1-2, then moves forward. And look at that delightful change of pace. On this rally so far. Serve, got away with it. Yeah, now I'm convinced in my mind that Royal Olympic champions
17.
Need to do more of that. They need to get on the attack more themselves. That way they'll drive Matsutomo back from the net area, make her defend. Well, I think they've got to take command. Two-time former champions here. Oh, that's a total asset. Quite a drift in
17.
The arena here, and it does make timing of the shots very difficult for the players if the shuttle is moving in flight. straight points. No, just 1 point
16,
in it.
17.
Just enough pace on it to
18,
make it awkward.
15.
Yeah. Yeah, she really is so good in the front court area.
17.
Xiao Yunlei. She hunts the shuttle here. Beautiful. Calmly just holds the shots, sees where her opponents are, and then just plays the shuttle into the open space.
Yeah.
Error on the backhand.
19,
could
17.
Be costly. Trying to keep it flat over the net. I understand completely the thought process there. So, three game point opportunities for the current world number ones. And that's gone wide, 21-17, opening game. Just a fraction under 20 minutes for that opening game. The number one seeds, Misaki Matsutomo and Ayaka Takahashi. Well, the two-time beaten finalists looking good at the moment against the two-time former champions. Yura on the return of serve, and no wonder she shakes her head. Quite simply, there's been too many unforced errors from the world and Olympic champions from China. But that's to take nothing away from the Japanese pair. They've played well. So head doubles coach for the women players, Tiang Bingyi, has taken his leave. As far as the Chinese pair are concerned, they're trying to reach their 20th Super Series tournament final.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Of course, for the Chinese pair, this is their first Super Series semi-final this year. Lost in the quarterfinal of both
game.
The All England and the Malaysia
Global.
Event last week. Oh, there's a challenge here. It's our first challenge of the semi-finals. No, it's very early on in a game for a challenge. Yeah, it was in. The line judge was right. Umpire Well, she has got her back to the giant screen, and therefore I'm not sure she's aware that Hawkeye has called the shuttle in. She's still waiting for a response, I think. Now she's looking up to where Hawkeye is. Yeah, it was definitely in. The line judge was right. The challenge has been unsuccessful. But of course, the umpire can't see the giant scoreboard. So the tournament referee has had to come on and confirm the
challenge unsuccessful
call by Hawkeye. Pincho Stoynov from Bulgaria, the tournament referee.
One lap. Play.
Oh, beautiful drop shot again. Well, she did that in the early stages of the opening game, didn't she? Ayaka Takahashi. Takahashi, that's her first service error of the match. In fact, I think it is the first service error of the match. We've had two service faults. Yeah, there we are. That's confirmed. Yeah, good smash. Playing flat, fast
three,
exchanges
four.
With Zhao Yunlei. There's a reason why she has two Olympic gold medals. Not to mention the five World Championship gold medals. Yeah, it's clever placement. Aiming towards the left hip of Takahashi. Back level. Moment of indecision at the back of the court from Zhao Yunlei cost her dear, because from that moment on she had to hit the shuttle in an upward direction, which gave her opponents the attack. Look at that. Oh, another service error. Takahashi. Yeah. Oh, my goodness, it's contagious.
Serve over. 6-0.
Is that the first flick serve
that's
of this semi-final?
7-6.
Service fault called again
on
Tiang Qing.
Once
again, deemed to have struck the shuttle above the waist. Can't help but wonder whether Xu Shen coming into the courts around, because a shuttle from the adjoining court had come on, whether that just distracted the Chinese players a little. There he is. Well, I'm surprised the umpire didn't call the let. 73 shots. A risky shot from Tiang Qing. Well, she got away with it. Playing a block as loose as that across court, but Takahashi just couldn't stretch high enough to deal with it. No, that's it. I should have deliberately left that one. Now the umpire's got the score on.
Nine.
We're back on track, 9-0. Attacking play.
11-9.
And the two-time forward champions, Yang Qing and Zhao Yunlei, have the advantage at the mid-game interval. 2-point advantage, to be precise. Yeah, aiming towards that right hip, and she gets caught. She's a defending backhand. telling the coaches to leave the court. On this advantage, more than Olympic champions. That's a gift. It does occur to me to wonder why the Japanese pair, who attack so well in the opening game, why they're now content to defend. Now, I can see that head women's doubles coach Tian Bingyi was having a word with the tournament referee. The tournament referee has now moved to just behind the court. I guess that's probably because of the service faults called on Tian Qing. That's clever. Good use of the midcourt area. And that's why the Japanese pair, I don't particularly like having Takahashi at the front of the court, because she doesn't hunt the shuttle in the same way. And therefore it does leave that mid-court area behind the front court player, but in front of the rear court player. It does leave that a little bit vulnerable. Not when they're in this formation, though, because Matsutomo is working well at the front of the court to intercept. Like that. Brilliant. Just been the second quick serve of the match. Oh, nice drop. This is a good rally. Oh, brilliant smash to finish it from Ayaka Takahashi, across the body towards the right hip of Zhao Yunlei. Just watch the placement of this. That's nigh on perfect. Brilliant. Brilliant placement against a player who's won three titles here in Singapore. Not only her two women's doubles titles, but last year the mixed doubles with Jiang Nan. Serve. 30. Opportunity was there, and she knows it. Look at the disappointment. They'd forced the short lift. And perhaps could have taken half a step further forward. Look, she's sort of leaning towards it rather than getting underneath it.
Let's go.
drops a racket on the floor in disappointment. But that's the difference between the two Japanese players. She just doesn't look as confident at the front of the court when she's forced to play that front court area. Defense. Yeah, it was a flatter smash this time from Takahashi towards Zhao Yunlei. Towards her left shoulder. Look at that. Forced the weak reply, and therefore the opportunity for the front court player to make the interception. That was good defense. See how she turned and played the forehand? Forehand defensive shot. That was good. So 15 all. Oh, there's another flat smash as well. 15. This time at Tiang Qing. Three straight points. Tsutomu and Takahashi once again go back into the lead. To the Japanese pair, because since I made that comment that why on earth were they defending, they've been looking to get on the attack again. Yeah. 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 The lift was nowhere near the back of the court, and it got what it deserved from Zhao Yunlei. Yeah, that one. Look how short it is. You can see from the position of the feet of Zhao Yunlei. It was only about half court. Good serve. Yeah, good smash. Change of direction. Smash down the forehand side, then down the backhand side. There's the forehand. Next one comes down the backhand side. And very, very slightly slow to react to that. That's clever play by Chinese pair. So, level once again. 17 all. Sense it too. Oh, well, did Takahashi take her eye off the shuttle? She was there.
17.
Did she have her eye on her opponents? Look, she's there. She could have played it. service fault called. That's the fourth time she's been called a fault on her serve, Tiang Qing. Time, I don't disagree. Yeah, there's confirmation it was the fourth. She was going to leave it, then realized she needed to play it. Oh, that's delightful. That is absolutely magnificent. What a beautiful defensive shot. Forehand defense, the block to the net. And now two match point opportunities. Look at that. Super. Played one very loose block across court. She got away with it, but that's a much, much better shot. So one of the match points, well saved. But another one remains. Well, all credit to the two-time former champions because they got themselves on the attack and they maintained that attack throughout the rally to that final shot. So, two match points have come and gone. It's 20-all and we will require extra points until there's a clear two-point winning margin. Japanese players have to put those match point opportunities out of their minds. Important serve. Serve too. Oh yes, well taken. Well taken indeed by Zhao Yunlei. So having just saved two match points, and now the former champions have a game point opportunity. Done it. Would you believe it? from 18-20 down four straight points. And we will be treated to a third and deciding game in this women's doubles semi-final. 48 minutes into the match, and it's all level at one game apiece. Yeah, the error on the return of serve. Well, you never, never write off this Chinese pair. His thoughts. The two-time winners of this event, Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei, never beaten here in Singapore as a pair, because this is only their third visit to this tournament. Well,
play.
They walked to the edge of the precipice in that second game, didn't they? Had a little look, decided they didn't like what they saw. And they have come back. And are still in this semi-final.
One double, one love.
My goodness. Oh. Missed by a considerable margin.
Left over. One, all.
Oh, a mere 54 shots. 73 in the second game, didn't we? Now, umpire is calling for the tournament referee. Well, somebody's wanting some spray, I think, for one of the players. Some sort of injury. Pencho Stoynov of Bulgaria will send for the medic. Yeah, left ankle. No, she doesn't seem too upset by it. Smiling at her partner. It really was a tremendous rally, wasn't it, that last one? exchanges. Yeah, now that's what the problem was. I thought at the time, did she twist her ankle? Is that why she went down? There was definitely something happened there. Ankle gave way. Just testing to see whether she can continue. Of course, with it being Olympic year, nobody wants to risk a serious injury. Here we go. Oh, yes. Oh, I didn't like that. I did not like that. You could see the ankle going right over there. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that looked nasty. Yeah, it really did. Yeah, that was not nice. I didn't like that at all. No wonder she's called for the medic. Now I think they'll probably need to strap that. Have they strapped it? No, that could have been very, very nasty. I think she's going to be all right. Knee support either. There we go. So drama at the beginning of this deciding game. Trying to pressurize her now. She's picked up that injury. Everything going to Matsutoma. Push her to the back and brought her forward. But I think it was a mistake to bring her forward because that gave the opportunity to Takahashi to move to the back of the court and use her good smash. Oh, a number of Japanese fans in here. Started with a good flick serve. I wonder if that was their first flick serve. Yes, it was. Thank you. Oh, clever. Clever, clever play from Matsu Tomo. Full stretch, first of all, then sees the gap. And it's a simple, just placing the shuttle into the open space. Yeah, but it's the vision to see that's where the gap is. That's what's impressive as well, not just the final shot. Super. What a wonderful disguised cross-court drop shot from Tian Qing. That is magnificent. How she created that angle, I do not know. Fabulous shot. Shake of the head because she knows she probably would be better to play a backhand there. We're all off balance trying to play the round the head shot. Taken. Yeah. Well, the match clock ticks over the hour mark, and it's one game all and five all. An hour of badminton, and these two pairs cannot be separated. Oh, regularly 40 shot plus rallies. Shot again that time. That time it worked for her.
Six, five.
She doesn't lift her back foot when she's serving. It's not called as a fault. No, that one was fine.
Plus over. Six, seven.
Oh. errors like that in a match as close as this. It's a good return of serve. Yeah, immediately put. Olympic champions under pressure. Yeah, it's good variation on the attacking play there from Zhao Yunlei. Challenge. There's a challenge here from the Japanese pair. Yes, it's their first challenge of this semi-final. Oh, it's Plum on the line. Online judge. Chinese pair taking too long in between rallies. Oh, yes, that's a great interception from Matsutomo. Well, Matsutomo didn't want to change the shuttle. Says that the Chinese pair can change it. That's unusual, I have to say. When the servers don't want to change the shuttle, then umpires usually side with the servers. Unbelievable, but it's gone wide. Well, there was no one covering that defensive shot. Unfortunately, for the two-time former champions from China, it went wide. Look, both the Chinese players encroaching into the net. Who's covering that one? No one. There was a huge gap. Zhao Yunlei should have moved out. Yeah, they were lucky.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Well, in my opinion, whichever of these two pairs manages to get themselves on the attack and manages to involve the net player is the pair who will be in the final tomorrow. Oh, they're never challenging that, surely. Well, that didn't even look close from where I'm sitting, but I am the far end. Oh, no, that's caught the line. That's caught the line. Yeah, certainly has. So they've both just got one challenge remaining now, both pairs. Took the chance coming forward, Zhao Yunlei, and that's what I was alluding to just a moment ago. Either Zhao Yunlei for the Chinese pair or Matsutomo, this lady, for the Japanese pair, have got to take risks going forward. And try and dominate that front court area. And whoever manages to do that, I think, will win this match. That was good courage from Zhao Yunlei. Got caught, committed to the backhand defence, Zhao Yunlei. And I'm surprised, considering the obvious smash, the obvious attack, was straight down the line. Yeah, still trying to play that smash down her forehand side with the backhand action. Look at that. Serve is long. He's played an awful lot of flick serves.
13-11.
Oh, yes. Take your chance at the front of the court. So often it pays dividends. Look at that. That's lovely. Drop shot and a half smash. And that variation in pace makes getting into the defensive groove very difficult. Well, the first time since the very first rally of this deciding game, Japanese pair go into the lead. Matsutomo. My goodness me. Well, What was it I was saying about taking your chances going forward? Didn't she do that well in that rally? That was the one that made the difference. This one. So, 5 straight points. Time backhand forces the error. 17. Make that 6 straight points. From 11-13 down. Confusion with the Japanese pair, they went the wrong sides. Got away with it. Yeah. There she is again. And it's the interception at the net that's making a huge difference now. 7 straight points. Points away, world number ones from a third final here. 53 shots. That's good defense. Yeah, follows it up with a magnificent cross-court smash.
14, 18.
That's gone long.
2 points
required for a third opportunity to contest the final. Yeah. Well, it's not often we've seen Tian Qing intercept at the net. She did there very effectively. Oh, that's always gone wide. It's gone wide. And there's more match point opportunities here for the Japanese pair. Remember, they had 2 match point opportunities in the second game, but failed to convert. They've got another 5 opportunities right now. So match point number 3. Good serve. Yeah. positive rally. Yeah, I like that block. And this time, the world number ones, Misaki Matsutomo and Ayaka Takahashi, convert. And they will tomorrow contest a third final here at the Singapore Open. They're still looking for a first ever title at this particular event, but they've come through against the former champions, the world and Olympic champions, Tian Qing and Xiao Yun Lei. 1 hour, 20 minutes. This is the final rally. The error on the backhand from Tian Qing. So safely through to a third final. Matsutomo and Takahashi. Three games needed, though, for their victory. So 21-17, 20-22, 21-16. In the deciding game.
Play on court one, women's double, Misaki Matsutomo.
So before our next semi-final, a chance for us to look at the Destination Dubai rankings in the mixed doubles. And the winners from last week in Malaysia, Tuntoi Ahmad and Liliana Nasir, have shot up 12 places to number two on the ranking. The beaten finalists from last week, the home players Chan Peng Soon and Go Liu Ying, shot up a